Hey, what's going on, you guys? Check this out, man. Your boy back at it with another video. And for today's video, we got ourselves a female who seems to think that it's okay to rip open packages in the store before she buys them. Not only do she thinks it's okay, she thinks the nerve of the employees checking her on the buffoonery, son. I ain't even gonna hold you, okay? Apparently, this is Waka Flocka's wife or something, you heard? This is Tammy Riviera. I don't know what the name is. Tammy's in the river somewhere. I don't know what they call her, but I need you to check this video out, and we gonna get right back in.
CVS. I come here almost every other night. I know every person that works in this store. I came here to get some satin hair wrap and some dew growth oil. This lady sat here. She must be new. She sat here and she watched me on the aisle, acting like she was fixing stuff in the aisle. I'm watching her watch me, right?
She was opening packages.
I opened the pack. She said, Becky, she watched Chuck. She's watching me so hard that when I opened this pack, she said, "Don't do that." I said, "Who are you talking to?" No, I said, "Who are you talking?" You didn't say please. Yes. I said, "Who are you talking to?"
I said,
"Don't do that." I said, "If I'm buying this, I can do what I want." "No, you cannot. Don't do that." I said, "You've been watching me this whole..." Pull the cameras back. You did. Pull the cameras back.
Okay.
Pull the cameras back. What you thought was I was a child or someone stealing because you sat there and you watched me for 2 hours and I watched you watch me and I didn't say anything. Okay. Not one thing.
I work here, yes.
Yeah, you do work here. And I come in here almost every other night. Every employee who works here knows me but her. She must be new. But she sat there and watched me on the aisles. She sat there and watched me on the aisles and told me to not open. And it was the mannerism in which she spoke to me like I was a child. "Don't do that. Why are you watching me from 2 hours away telling me not to open something that I'm about to pay for?"
That is
very damning. And then she would tell me to leave the store. I told her to call the police.
And I did.
Girl.
And she's still running her mouth. And she's still running her mouth. And you're still running your mouth. And you're about to be on Instagram to 7.5 million followers. So laugh at that.
The only reason why I'm doing this story, the sole reason why I'm even covering this, is for the simple fact that this woman is receiving an overwhelming amount of support, okay? And your boy Breathe Easy likes to take dumps on parties, okay? They call your boy the party pooper, son. Straight up and down, your boy's taking a squat on this one, B. I ain't even gonna hold you because Shorty Doo-Wop's in the wrong. Are you guys dumb? Are you guys that much of sheep that somebody who is clearly in the wrong, 100%, sometimes I like cutting it down the middle. Y'all know how I give it up, you feel me? Even if somebody's doing something crazy, I'll still be like, "Yeah, but maybe they were young or maybe they had bad parents or something." Like, I don't know. I'll come up with something. But there's nothing here, son. Hey, man, first of all, the entitlement in this video is so real, it's not even funny, B. You are exposing a woman at her job to 1. Whatever million amount of followers you got, but got the nerve to be like, "And she's still talking." You're still talking. You're the one got a phone talking to your millions of followers complaining that this one is over here defending herself. And I'm glad she did. You want to know why I'm glad she did? Because we would have never found out about that part about you opening up the package. You see, you slipped up, mama. You didn't think that you was going to get involved with somebody who would stick up for themselves. And y'all know how I give it up, man. Right is right and wrong is wrong. She's in the wrong, okay? When she first started off that video, she was making it seem as if she was just going, you know what I mean, down the aisle looking at stuff, and you had the typical Asian store worker over here suspecting that this black woman is stealing. We already know the stories, which is why I gotta go hard on this one, because there's been too many people to suffer the real life consequences of shopping in a store that's ran by a bunch of people who don't rock with them like that. There are real life consequences to that. So my issue right now is the fact that you over here crying wolf when there's a bunch of people getting eaten up by wolves out here. Straight up and down, B. I ain't even gonna hold you. You in the wrong, son. She would have never brought up the fact that she was opening up the package herself. She herself was opening up the package. Yeah, I know. We all do that. But it's not like we're doing it in front of the employees. Everybody that I know that opens up the packages, they're making sure that the employees don't see them Why? Because they're gonna think that they're stealing, Dodo. Stop playing with me, son. And listen, I'm gonna be honest with you. You wanna know some, you hear me? I steal. You feel me? If I'm opening up the package, your boy trying to squeeze past the metal detectors undetected, okay? Straight up and down. I call it a protest, baby. We gotta keep loss prevention employed, son. Straight up and down. They got kids to feed too, son. Straight up and down. So your boy out here, you hear me? Stealing and all of that. But I ain't out here saying, hey, cashier, look, you want to tuck it into my and walking out the store. It don't work like that, man. Right is right and wrong is wrong. And I don't care how pretty someone is. I don't care who she's married to. I don't care what the affiliations are. Stop being sheep, because there's real life situations that go on. And when y'all crying wolf like this, you know what I mean? Somebody else who's really going through it, people aren't going to pay as much as attention to that, B. Stop playing with us, B. That's wrong. You're in the wrong. And I love cutting it down the middle. But mama, you gave me nothing here. You gave me, how is somebody supposed to talk to you if they think you're stealing? Even if you wasn't stealing, you're doing something you're not supposed to do. And honestly, she just said, stop doing that. And honestly, I believe she said, please. I actually do believe that. Sorry, I don't care. Believe me, like, I believe that she said, please. But even if she didn't say, please, the audacity and the entitlement of you to even feel like she should be talking to you with kitty gloves after she's witnessing you doing something that you're not supposed to be doing. Stop it. And y'all need to stop doing that too, because y'all are really tuning in and playing in to the hands and shit, trying to divide and conquer. This isn't something that, and CVS, hold on, my bad, I keep on jumping around, but CVS is launching an investigation now. CVS is launching an investigation to this poor woman over here trying to do her job. All she was trying to do is do her job. And let me tell you something, and before I get out of here, because my phone's dying, I gotta make this quick. I don't know what it is. I guess women love her. Like, y'all love her. And I'm not mad at it. All right, you feel me? But she's wrong. You feel me? I don't care. She's wrong, B. I don't care. And you know what's crazy? I think it's because people are so used to this type of dynamic going the other way. Like the Asian store worker versus the black customer. You feel what I'm saying? So, like, it's so easy because we've seen so many videos of how, you know what I mean? We already know how the dynamics go. But this isn't it, y'all. This is not it. Hey, yo, Asian shorty door up. Better sue mama for you. They got money, son. They got money. Your boy, listen, if that was me, I would have just fell on the floor, B. I would have just fell on the floor and be like, yo, you just hit me. You just hit me with your richness or something. Like, straight up in there, B. Yeah, boy, getting the chickens. Straight up in there. I ain't even gonna hold you, B. But that's how I feel about the situation. Y'all gotta stop being sheep. Y'all gotta stop being sheep. But you know what, though? I'm gonna give you a little bit of, you know what it is? And now I can kind of see it. And what it is, if you have a major following and somebody disrespects you or somebody does you wrong, or at least you feel like somebody does you wrong, it is so easy for you to just be like, oh, word? All right, well, 1.7 million people is about to see this and I'm about to get back at you. And I honestly can kind of understand that slightly, because there'd be times in myself, I'd be in a store waiting for somebody to act up, be like, yo, let's go live right now, son. Here we go. Hey, you guys, check this out, man. We got this bum-ass employee out here trying to disrespect the kid, me. And, like, I can see it now, because it's just, like, it's such a passive but very really good way to get at somebody. I'm losing the words or whatever, but it's something that I'm just now realizing that it could be used. This social media stuff can be weaponized. You know what I mean? If enough people follow you, if enough people are interested in what you got to say, you can weaponize that. You feel me? Like, you really could. You feel me? But I think what her issue is that you start to realize that turns people off. One, you feel me? Like, shorty's about to learn that the hard way. You know what I mean? I think some we all kind of do. You feel me? You're gonna learn that turns people off, especially if you're in the wrong. You feel what I'm saying? It's like, even if you're in the right, because people look at you as up here, so they look at you as punching down. You feel what I'm saying? Like, whenever and you know what I mean, I don't want to get through my personal thing, but like, if somebody looks at you as a certain status at a certain level, and then you turn around and then you attack somebody, regardless if you're in the right or the wrong, they're always gonna look at you as in the wrong, because you're punching down. They look at you as the bully, especially if you got one point. You're a rich lady married to Waka Flocka, and you got 1.7 million followers, and you was technically in the wrong. But even if you wasn't, you know what I mean? Like, it's a bad look. It's a very, very bad look. And so she kind of got a little bit. She let her emotions take the better of her. You feel me? I guarantee you, if she could look back, you know what I mean, in retrospect, she would have never did something like that. Straight up and down, I'm telling you right now. now. And I know where that's coming from. I know where that, because there's been a few times where I'm like, yo, man, keep playing with the kid, baby. You're going viral. Straight up in there. But nah, I'm saying it doesn't work. It gotta be something like a girl, like it gotta be like a cop, you know what I mean? Like doing something crazy, or it gotta be somebody that's really a degenerate, you feel me? That's really messing with you and you punching down at that. And hey man, we all learning. She gonna learn her lesson too, man. Straight up and down. But listen, and for all of you guys who support her, I have no idea where you're coming from. I have no idea why anybody would be on her side. I don't care. Listen, man, every now and then I like to pop up on this channel and kind of clean up the subscribers a little bit. I call this a cleaning, you feel me? Every time I do these type of videos, he was like, nah, this nigga's wildin', man. You don't know what he's talking about. Hey, man, you feel me? Straight up and down. Because she's bugging out, and your boy gonna call it out. Just like I call it out for everyone else, B. Ain't no favoritism out here, son. Straight up and down. I mean, I'ma stay on cold. Don't get it twisted. I'ma stay on cold. But I ain't gonna, you know what I mean? I ain't gonna fake it for you guys. Straight up and down. That's how I feel about the situation, baby. You already know the vibes. I got some fire content coming your way real, real soon. But in the meantime, I appreciate all the likes. Thank you. I appreciate all the loves. Thank you. And I appreciate all the subs. Thank you. And don't forget
Breathe easy.